What will come in the trading account on the credit side, we'll discuss. What come on the debit side and credit side of your trading account? Now, trading account, your heading would be trading account of the name of the person or the organization for the year or period ended, because trading account is for a particular year. So you have to mention the year for which, along with the last day of the year. Now this would be your heading, and as you know, it is a ledger format only. It is an account, so therefore it is a simple format. There is no need for your LF and date column. So on either side you would be having an amount column and simply a particulars column. So on either side there would be a amount column and a particulars column. And also, as usual, you know, the left hand side is debit and the right hand side is credit. Then next, if you see, this is particulars and this is amount. Then again particulars, amount. Now what are generally recorded? We already discussed, we have to record nominal accounts in trading and P&L account. So let us see some nominal accounts that appear in trading account. Usually, if you don't do the adjustments before preparing trial balance, then opening stock would be appearing on the debit side. Then there would be purchases. If at all purchases are given, gross purchases, you would be given purchase returns. So we minus purchase returns from purchases and take the value to the outer column. Then next we would be having wages. Now you all know what is wages, the amounts paid to your workers. These workers are directly involved with processing of your goods, so it is treated as a direct expense. So wages would appear. Then there would be some direct expenses. Now I'll give you the list of direct expenses separately, and as a result, some examples would be carriage, you can say fuel, excise duty, etc. These are few examples. All the other examples I'll list out separately. Now this minimum is there on the debit side. On the credit side, you have by sales, and from sales, if returns are given, sales returns, you minus sales returns. The net sales would be going to outer column. Then on the credit side, you will also have closing stock, if at all it exists, and provided you have not adjusted the purchases. That is, when opening stock is there on the debit side, there is a possibility of closing stock appearing on the credit side. Then next, these minimum, the difference, if the credit side is more, the difference we will be writing as two gross profit carried down. When we have gross profit, I'm putting the condition, when credit side total is more than debit side total. So when credit side total is more than debit side total, the balancing figure is regarded as your gross profit.